So, in this video, this is a video for mathematics. In this video, I used to do the solution of a question paper. So, let me continue. Last time, I have solved unit 1. Question number 2. Now today I am going to solve unit 2, and this is question number 5A. In fact, in unit 1 there were 2 questions, either do 2 or do 3. In unit 2 also there are 2 questions, either do 4 or 5. So I have chosen the questions from the examination points of view, that is shorter questions, the questions which can be done very easily, very simple, in 3 hours. So the next question which I am going to take is not 4 but 5 from unit 2, because from unit 1 also you have to do either of one, from unit 2 also you have to do either of them, in between a big or is written. So I have chosen the smart way, that is the simple questions which take less time. Okay, so question number 5A, the problem is a heavy particle slides down a smooth cycloid starting from rest at the cusp axis being vertical and vertex downward. Prove that pressure at the vertex will be 2 times the weight of the particle. So this is the question. So first of all, you should understand the question, what is given and what you have to obtain. It is given a heavy particle, that means particle is not of unit mass, it has some mass. Let us assume the mass is m. So heavy particle slides down a smooth cycloid, that means cycloid is not rough, it is smooth, from the cusp at rest. It was initially at rest at the cusp, and The cycloid is of the type whose vertex is downward. What we have to find? Prove that at the vertex, the pressure on the curve will be 2 times the mass of the particle. So this is the question. First of all, let us start. You know how I start solution. We draw a figure and then we write down the equations of motion and then we find out, we write what is given in the question. So what is given? Given, particle is moving on a cycloid. Is in a cycloid. So the very first thing is equation of a cycloid. Equation of a cycloid is S is equal to 4a sin sh. So our particle starts from the cusp. Now the next thing is initially particle is at cusp. What does it mean? It means the particle is here. This is cusp. And here, when you draw a tangent, you will see the tangent makes an angle pi by 2 with the horizon. The tangent makes an angle with the horizon, that is known as sin. So initially particle is here, S dot is 0, time is 0, what else? S is 4a sin psi, means S is 4a. Why? Because psi is pi by 2 and sin pi by 2 is 1. So these are the initial conditions. Particle starts from here. At any arbitrary time t, suppose particle reaches this position. So what are the forces now acting on p? Its weight vertically downwards along the tangent. Draw a line. It will make an angle psi with the horizon. At the point of contact, it will have a normal reaction r. Whenever two bodies are in contact, a normal reaction works, which is perpendicular to the tangent drawn at that point. So this is the tangent and this is the normal reaction. Okay, I hope the figure is clear. So it is at cusp, that means S is 4a, time is 0, S dot is 0. These are the initial conditions given for the particle. And what is asked to prove? What you have to prove? The pressure at the lowest point. Pressure at O, lowest point. You have to prove this is equal to 2 times mg. I hope the question is clear. Now let us see how to do it. So to do any arbitrary question, I told you, first try to understand the problem, then write down the equations of motion, and then try to understand the type of motion, and finally what you have to obtain, in which form you have to obtain. So we will write down the equations of motion. Now how to write equations of motion? By using tangential acceleration and normal acceleration. You know, tangential acceleration is s double dot. Tangential acceleration is s double dot. So the force along the tangent will be ms double dot. This is mass into acceleration along the tangent. This is the tangent. Okay, so this must be equivalent to component of mg, because on the system there are only two forces, mg and r. So r will not have any effect along the tangent. It is in the normal direction. So only mg you have to consider. Now this angle is psi, so this angle will be, rest of the angle will be pi by 2 minus psi. Pi by 2 minus psi. So the component of mg along the tangent will be mg sin psi. Cos of 90 minus psi, that is mg sin psi. So, and of course it is in the negative direction. So this will be the first equation of motion. By resolving along the tangent, ms double dot is equal to minus mg sin psi. Now let us look for the second equation of motion. Second equation of motion will be obtained by the component perpendicular to the tangent, that means along the normal. So the normal acceleration, it is v square divided by rho. This is the formula I am using, and I will give you the list of the formulas which we have used in solving this question. So mv square by rho is equal to r minus mg cos psi. This is equation number 2. Why? Because component of mg in this direction will be mg cos psi. This is pi by 2 minus psi, means this is psi. So component of mg in this direction will be mg cos psi. So the net force r minus mg cos psi will act on this particle in the normal direction, and that is equivalent to mass into acceleration mv square divided by rho. With the help of these two equations only, you can get the complete motion. Now what is our target? Our target is to find the normal reaction at the vertex. This is the vertex. So normal reaction will be this r. So component of r we have to find at this very point. This is our target. So for that, we will integrate this equation and get the component for velocity. We'll substitute that velocity here and we'll get the value of r. This is what I am going to do. Now, to integrate equation 1, we multiply it by 2s dot. This is the procedure, very simple procedure to integrate this equation 2s dot. What I did? Simply multiply equation 1 by 2s dot on both the sides. Now we will integrate this equation. So we will get s dot square. Why? Because when you differentiate this, you will get 2s dot s double dot. Isn't it? So from here you will get s dot square. And from right hand side, you will get, you can substitute for sin psi. Sin psi will be minus 2g. Sin psi from the equation of cycloid, s is equal to 4a sin psi. So s upon 4a, and then
S dot.
Okay. So S dot square becomes minus G by 4A S square. Of course, S square divided by 2, 2 will cancel and you will get only this term plus the integration constant C. Now, how to find the value of C? You know, from the initial conditions, you calculate the value of C. Initially, it is given S is equal to 4A, S dot is equal to 0. Then this will imply the value of C. C becomes 4AG. Now put that value of C in this equation. So you will find S dot square is coming as G by 4A 16A square minus S square. Okay, so this is the expression I'm going to use here. Now let us see what happens. Put the value from 3 in equation 2. Call it 3. Put V square. This is V square. From 3 in equation 2. Now let us see what happens to R. Our target is to find the value of R. So first of all, in equation 2, isolate R. The value of R will become mv square by rho plus mg cos psi. Isn't it? This is our R. And we have to substitute from the value which we have obtained for V square and for rho. Now what is rho? Rho is the radius of curvature and you know S is equal to 4A sin psi is the equation to cycloid and rho is ds by d psi. Then it will be 4A cos psi. So we can substitute 4A cos psi. M by rho. And then for V square, G by 4A. And then 16A square minus S square. S is 4A sin psi. So it will become 16A square sin square psi. Is it okay? This is the value of V square. This is the value of rho. Now the first term is over. Second term is mg cos psi. So now we have almost done the question. You can observe this is 4m by 4a cos psi, 16a square minus 16a square sin square psi. What will happen to it? It will be 16a square cos square psi. You know, 1 minus sin square psi, that is cos square psi. okay? So it will be 16 a square and then cos square sha. So this 16 a square will cancel with the 16 a square in the denominator, and one of the cos sha will cancel, and what you are going to get, this mg cos sha plus mg cos sha, so that is 2mg cos sha. And at the lowest point at O, what is the value of sha? Sha is pi by 2. So what you will get, r is equal to 2mg. And this is what we wanted to find. The normal reaction at the lowest point will be 2 times the weight of the particle. I hope the problem is clear to all of you. Now I will explain the whole question in Hindi as well. देखिए, क्या दिया हुआ है आपको? एक पार्टिकल है जो साइक्लॉइड के अंदर मूव कर रहा है, और कहाँ से शुरू कर रहा है? कस्प से चलना शुरू कर रहा है. तो सबसे पहले जान लीजिए कस्प होता क्या है. कस्प क्या होता है? S is equal to 4a, time is 0, s dot is 0, that is the cusp. तो cusp से चलना शुरू करेगा, तो आप equation of motion लिखोगे, दो equation of motion लिखाएगी, s is equal, एक tangential acceleration से लिखाएगी, दूसरा normal acceleration से लिखाएगी, और तीसरा आप formula use करोगे, ds by d psi is equal to rho, और फर्स्ट इक्वेशन ऑफ मोशन सेकेंड इक्वेशन ऑफ मोशन को यूज करते हुए आप नॉर्मल रिएक्शन निकाल लोगे, और वर्टेक्स पे पाई बाई शाई को पाई बाई टू रख दोगे, तो 2mg आ जाएगा. दैट्स ऑल. नाउ इन द नेक्स्ट लेक्चर आई विल बी डूइंग 5b.